Whenever you're soldering, the solder needs to make a good bond to the parts that you're soldering onto. The metal of the parts and the metal of the solder need to come into direct contact with each other in order to create a good bond. But since metals naturally form an oxide layer because of the oxygen in the air, something is needed to remove that oxide layer. In my video about using solder, I mentioned a little bit about flux, which works well for removing that layer. Usually the solder that you use for electronics will already have flux within it, but it is also helpful to have flux available to use separately. Here I have some wires. The oxide layer on these wires is too thin to see, but it is still there. I already have some melted solder on my soldering iron. You can see that it does kind of stick to the wires, but it's mostly just sitting on the surface and not really bonding with the copper. As I move the solder around, it looks like it has some kind of skin on it. That skin is the oxide layer of the solder. The oxide layer is a barrier preventing the solder and copper from bonding together. Flux is used to remove the oxide layer from the copper and from the solder. The way it does this is kind of interesting. It doesn't do much at low temperatures, but when it heats up and gets near the temperature of melted solder, it becomes corrosive and gets rid of the oxide layer. The flux that I have here is a paste, but it can also be in different forms like a liquid. Watch this solder on the iron as it comes into contact with the flux. It's like that solder skin is just melting away. The solder gets shiny and behaves completely different when it touches the wires. Now let's go back and watch it again, but this time watch the wires. As the flux melts and sizzles, you can see the solder flow right behind it as it bonds to the wires. Instead of just sitting on top of the twisted wires, it has soaked down with the wires. Instead of looking crusty with the skin, the solder is shiny and looks wet. The shininess will go away as the solder cools down, but that's normal. There's another thing that I want to mention about using flux. You can see here that after I apply the solder, it looks like there's a burn mark on the board next to it. That's actually residue from the flux, and it should be cleaned off. You can use isopropyl alcohol to scrub it off. I'm using a little scrub brush with it, but a cotton swab would also work. That's it for now. Stay tuned for the next video in my soldering basics series.